First of all, I want to talk about some of the history of Bill's pick. Bill Rasmussen and his son Scott founded ESPN in 1978. It was Bill's idea, but he asked his son for help. In the same year, they got a transponder set. This would allow them to air their shows all over the U.S. to houses that have cable. Even though the idea was made in 1978, ESPN only became a legitimate company on September 7, 1979. There are some turning points that ESPN had either achieved or done that have been major milestones for them. One significant turning point is when the Getty Oil Company invested $15 million into the company in 1984. Ultimately, this proved to people that ESPN probably had a lot of growth potential, and it was a good company. Years later, Getty Oil dropped their investment. Another huge milestone was that ESPN in 1998 acquired the rights to air a full season of the NFL. This helped ESPN because a lot of people liked to watch football, and it showed people that ESPN could air big-time sports events and air them well. Most importantly, ESPN has lots of business strategies that have really brought ESPN to the success it has today. The main business strategies that have made ESPN so successful is their regular update with the new technology. They're constantly trying to solve problems and take initiative if something is not working out perfectly. Also, ESPN have consistently been great risk takers, and perhaps this is the most important, ESPN never forgot the fans. The tech ESPN has is unbelievably advanced and complex. For instance, ESPN has a building in their headquarters / studio in Bristol, Connecticut. That building is called DC2. It stands for Digital Control 2. It is the most advanced digital control in the world. Also, around 16 years ago, ESPN had only 3 channels. Now ESPN has about 20, and you can watch ESPN anywhere, like their mission statement. Serving sports fans anywhere, anytime. You can watch ESPN on mobile devices, tablets, on the internet, Roku, Apple TV, and regular television. ESPN having really awesome tech really helps their company because it helps them have better streaming for their viewers, and a lot of people like really advanced tech because it just makes their watching experience better. ESPN's problem solving is really important to the company. This is because for pretty much all companies, you come across all sorts of problems, and ESPN is one of the best companies in software. ESPN once actually had a cell phone company, and they thought that this would help them promote the network a lot and it would get them higher profits. Well, that was not the case. Their phone company was actually costing them a lot, and they were not making enough. Also, it was just wasting their time. So they got rid of the phone company and kept moving on. This is one of the most important strategies ESPN has. ESPN is always taking risks. All companies should take risks, and ESPN does. And it really helps them thrive. Like I mentioned earlier, ESPN took a big risk making a phone company. They also started a restaurant. And they were one of the first companies to sign Sports Illustrated. And that actually turned out very well for them. They now have lots of magazines, and they are very successful. And all because they took that chance. Perhaps this is the most important trait ESPN has. They never forgot the fans. Think about it. The fans want better streaming experience. ESPN gives them that with the tech they have. If there is something fans don't like or don't attend, ESPN will solve that problem. Also, if the fans want something but it is risky somehow, ESPN will do their very best to make that happen. But the bottom line is, ESPN is successful because they really replicate what their mission statement is. Serving sports fans anywhere, anytime. There are countless ways ESPN serves the fans. Here are a few examples. ESPN has about 100 million fans in counting. If they weren't all about the fans, they would definitely not have as much. That's just obvious. Also, you know how ESPN has those funny commercials? Well, the fans started to love them so much that they kept them up, and they made a show just for. featured in commercials. If you don't know what the commercials are, here are a few of them. Sunday night's game. On to you.